Hey everyone, this is Raja, Enterprise Agile Coach from ProXL Consulting. So now, coming on to the last two reasons, reason number 6 and 7. Delivery through small baby steps is always better than a huge delivery by the end of the development life cycle. Especially because when the requirements are ambiguous and the customers do not know everything that they want, if you ask them, tell me what are the top 5 or 6 requirements that you really want, and develop that, do a requirements, do a design, code it, test it, show a working software to the client, and let the client see that working software and tell them, yeah, this is fine, this is what I expected, but this part is not I wanted, but I want something more also. So the understanding of the customer will go much higher if you quickly show working software. So delivery through small baby steps are much better than single huge delivery by the end of the development life cycle. That is why we should go to Agile. And frequent reflections by the development team is very important. When every software development is a discovery by itself, then you have to reflect on what you learned and what should you improve. What do we do right now in the traditional software development life cycle? We do some reflections, that is mostly by the end of the development life cycle. End of the project, you do a project retrospection meeting, or some projects call this as a project closure meeting, or in some other name. So that is too late. Even if you learn a lot of new things, or if you want to change a lot of things, it is already too late. It is already end of the project. Most probably you can use this learning in the next project, but again, next project is going to be new discovery. The requirements or the background may change in the new project. So it may or may not be useful in the new project. Or some projects do a retrospection meeting during every milestone. Say for example, at the end of requirements phase, you may do a retrospection meeting. But again, you will discuss everything about what did you do wrong in the requirements phase by the end of that milestone. Again, where are you going to use it? Requirements are already completed. You are going to jump into design phase. So probably it may not be useful for your project, this current project. Probably it may be useful for some other project, but not in this project. So we need to do a lot of frequent reflections within the project. This is what Agile does. At the end of every iteration, that's what Agile calls a parallel step-by-step complete delivery. End of every iteration, the project team sits with the customers, the end users, and their managers and discuss what went right, what went wrong, what should we improve, is this what you really wanted. We do all those reflections, and in this same similar 1 year project we spoke about, this reflection happens almost end of every month. So you do 12 times the reflection in an Agile project, whereas you do only once or at the maximum 2 or 3 times. Let me spend a little bit more time on explaining how Agile does it differently. Ambiguous requirements. Agile understand requirements will always be ambiguous. Agile understand customer may not know everything in the beginning. So every Agile project start with what you currently know and tell me the topmost 5 or 6 features or requirements that you want in this product. We will quickly show you your working software. After seeing the working software, then you are free to add new changes, yeah, new requirements. So requirements changes are welcome in Agile. We don't stop the customer to change their mind. We encourage the customer to change their mind based on what is already shown to them. And big upfront planning is not done in Agile. Planning does happen in Agile, but it happens over a period of time. There is a release planning, there is a iteration planning, there is a daily planning, various planning happens, but in Agile, we do just-in-time planning. For example, you may not see any schedule or a Gantt chart of say 8 months from now, what developer A will do and what activity he will work on. You may not see that in an Agile project. That schedule will happen on the end of 7th month. So at best, you will have every monthly plan and a very high level overall plan. Otherwise, we don't do complete upfront planning in Agile. Reviewing the working software, that is the major cornerstone of Agile. As we discussed earlier, we show the working software at the end of every month or every 2 weeks, if possible. So we show the working software to the client and ask the client to evaluate the working software and give additional ideas. And we do it more frequently. And as the saying goes, we show the working software to the client as early as possible and as often as possible. And Agile, all Agile development lifecycle is iterative and incremental. We don't do a complete big bang approach of development, no sequential approach. It is iterative and incremental. And the delivery is done through small baby steps. We already discussed that. Small iterations, every monthly iteration, and frequent reflections by the development community along with the customers to understand what went right, what went wrong, what should we improve, and what else do you need.